Hi, let's talk about the surface anatomy of the lungs. In this video, I'll describe the right and left lungs' surface anatomy, including fissures, lobes, apices, bases, hyla. We'll also differentiate between the left and the right lungs. So let's get started with surfaces. There are three major surfaces of the lungs. There are costal surfaces, which are everything here in blue. The costal surfaces are going to face the costal pleurae, which line the ribs in the intercostal spaces. There's also the mediastinal surface. The mediastinal surface is everything here in yellow, and it faces the mediastinum and the mediastinal pleura. It's this surface which hosts the hyla of the lungs, and the contents of the hyla are the roots of the lungs. And then the third surface is the diaphragmatic surface, also known as the base of the lung. The diaphragmatic surface is everything here in green, which will face the diaphragmatic pleura as well as the diaphragm. And then finally, the most superior portion of the lung is known as the apex. So the apices of the lungs will face the cervical pleurae up towards the roots of the neck. In terms of gross features, lungs consist of lobes. Typically, the right lung is going to have three lobes, a superior or upper lobe, a middle, and an inferior or lower lobe, whereas the left lung typically only has two lobes, a superior and an inferior. So there's no middle lobe for the left lung. These lobes are separated by fissures, and it's into these fissures that the visceral pleurae are going to dive deep to help separate these lobes. There is an oblique fissure. The oblique fissure separates the superior from the inferior on the right side, as well as the middle from the inferior. On the left lung, the oblique fissure simply separates the superior from inferior. And on the right lung, there's also a horizontal fissure, which separates the superior lobe from the middle. So that middle lobe is flanked by both horizontal and oblique fissures on either side of it. Again, there are apices at the top that are going to be of the superior lobes. There's going to be bases or diaphragmatic surfaces on the bottoms, which are going to largely be associated with the inferior lobe, but on the right side may partially be associated with that middle lobe. The mediastinal surface is what hosts the hilum. So the hilum of an organ is where the neurovasculature may enter and leave. We can see that here. The hilum is going to have many different contents. The contents are known as the root of the lung. So in this case, the major contents are going to include the primary bronchi, which we can see here in yellow, the pulmonary arteries, which I can see here in blue, and then finally the pulmonary veins, which I can see here in red. In addition to these features, the left lung also has a cardiac notch, which we can see here, that is going to be that space to accommodate the apex of the heart. And the inferior portion of that cardiac notch, and we can see that a little better here, supplied by the superior lobe, has a lingula. A lingula. So we've discussed the various surfaces and gross features of the lungs, as well as the hyla and the contents of the hyla, the roots of the lung, which include primary bronchi, pulmonary arteries, and pulmonary veins. This is your summary slide. Thank you for your time.